వెల్కమ్ టు పునర్వసి టెక్నాలజీస్. www.punarvasi.com ఈజ్ మై వెబ్సైట్. ఐ రోట్ మెనీ ఆర్టికల్స్ ఆన్ SAP బేసిస్ అడ్మినిస్ట్రేషన్ ఇన్ దిస్ వెబ్సైట్. మెనీ పీపుల్ గాట్ బెనిఫిటెడ్ ఫ్రమ్ మై ఆర్టికల్స్ అండ్ ఐ హ్యావ్ ట్రైన్డ్ అండ్ హెల్ప్డ్ పీపుల్ ఇన్ మోర్ దాన్ 50 కంట్రీస్. మై నేమ్ ఈజ్ మిస్టర్ రాజ్. ఐఎమ్ సాఫ్ట్వేర్ అండ్ వెల్ బీయింగ్ కోచ్. ఇన్ దిస్ వీడియో ఐ ఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ యూ హౌ టు ఇన్స్టాల్ ఏ లాంగ్వేజ్ within solution reminder system. Okay, this is my solution reminder system. In this I'll demonstrate how to install the separate language, that is English and German language are default languages. If you want to have other languages, the interface, if you want to have other interface, you need to import the language. Okay, first of all you need to check the T code called I18N to add the language. Double click on here. And from here, click on the add button. F4, and I am going to install Spanish language. For the Spanish language, the code is ES. So this is the language code. Hit enter. So once you add here, click on the activate button from the application toolbar and new NLS configuration will be activated. Continue. Click on the yes button. And click on the go back button from here. Now just again go back. From here, to import any language, the T code is SMLT. And before going to SMLT, just if you want to find out the language codes and all, you can find that information from the SE16 T code. It will be used to browse the tables, that is T002 is the table where you will have all the details about different languages and codes. And these are all the codes, like for suppose ES, this is Spanish, and the number letter S is for providing the configuring the parameter within the solution reminder system. I'll show you how to configure this parameter. Okay, just remember this S. Okay, I have already installed Portuguese language in this system. Okay, so that I have already created the parameter. Just I have to edit that parameter to add this particular S. Okay, so let us go to SMLT T code. Hit enter. From here, we should be able to click on the language and click on the language and put the Spanish from here. Okay, click on the save button. Do you want to save? Click on the yes button. Okay, language key ES successfully saved. Now the Spanish language, nothing is there here. You need to import the package. Okay, select the Spanish, click on the language and click on the import package. Before clicking on the import package, what you have to do is you have to put the related language file into the EPS directory. So let me show you that. Like for suppose ES is the folder which I have downloaded. So from here you have two files. Out of those two files, just you have to copy this PAT file, go to C drive USR, SAP, Trans Directory, EPS, in. So this particular file is related to Portuguese language. This is Spanish language. Portuguese already have installed, so that I can delete that. Portuguese, delete. Okay, so now let us select Spanish, click on the language, click on the import package, select a language. Okay, so find packages, so like this it will find the package, and this is the ES. Yes, the file is ES. Whatever the file you have selected, whatever the file you copied, just select entire line, click on the execute button, import package, click on the yes button. Okay, so import schedule, the job is scheduled, you have to wait for some time, so to finish this particular job. Okay, so you can close the screen from here. Okay, and now in the Spanish, import packages, so like this transport truck symbol will be visible, and from here action log you can locate, or you can click on the job information. From here you can find out whether this job is successfully completed or not. You can click on the job details, so it will show all the job details, and also you can click on the job log so that we can view the information from here, job finished. Okay, so now, so let us look at the, okay, it is not yet finished, just you need to get the, like this, imported completely, like message you should be able to see, job, click on the job information, click on the job log. Job finished. It is showing job finished, but it's still running. You can also check this information from the SM37. It is already in the SM37. You can go back SM37. You can find out all the jobs that are running right now. Okay, language import. It is finished. Job is finished. Okay, now just you have to add the letter in the parameter. RZ10 is the T code for maintaining profile parameters. So from here you have to select default profile and go to extended maintenance, click on the change button, and this is the, where is that, this is the language related parameter, ZCSA/install_languages. If you have not already created this parameter, if you are not able to see this parameter, you can click on the create parameter button from here, and you can choose the parameter name like this. Click, hit F4 from here and click on the this arrow mark, ZCSA and start, so that it will display all the parameters which starts with ZCSA. So like this, ZCSA install languages. So like this, if you double click on hit here, it will show like this. Okay, so just you have to add S here. Okay, as I have already able to see this particular parameter, just double click on this parameter, just add the S letter here. Okay, click on enter, click on the copy button and go back, again copy. Okay, and click go back and click on the save, and incorrect parameter values detected, click on the no. And do you want to activate the profile? Click on the yes. And profile default saved and activated, click on the continue button. Okay, so once it is saved, you must log off from the system, and you have to restart the SAP system from here. Right click, click on the stop button, click OK. Once it is completely stopped, again you start it. Okay, click refresh here, Okay, I'm just pausing the video. Again, once it is started, just I will start it and I'll come back. Okay. Okay, it's almost started. Wait, and yes, just double click on Solution Manager 7.1 to log on. Now, just DDIC and the password and the language is ES. Okay, hit enter. So it should log on and it should show the Spanish language interface. So if it shows Spanish language interface, your installation of language, importing of language pack is successfully done. In the same way, if you want to log in as Portuguese, it is Spanish. Okay, you have to use PT as the language code here to see the Portuguese. So let us wait and log off and log in as Portuguese language so that you will completely understand how it will work. Okay, Spanish language completely not showing. Yes, it's almost Spanish language it is. And now let us log off and log in as Portuguese. PT. It's Portuguese language. Okay. So, I hope you understood. Thank you for watching this video. If you like my video, you can buy my further videos from my website, that is www.punarvasi.com. Sorry, from here. Basis videos. I am providing 109 videos on SAP basis administration just for $199. You can also join my one-to-one online training on SAP basis training, that is for $1199. And also I'll give this training at your premise for 1 week's time. I'll come to your premise and deliver the training for $1500. You have to bear my travel expenses and accommodation expenses to avail this particular option. I hope you understood. Thank you for watching this video. Have a wonderful day.